पादोदकं यस्य भवव्याधिनाशकं वचनामृतं यस्य ज्ञानभक्तिदायकं करुणामृतं यस्य खलु शब्दमुक्तिदं शरणं तमेकं सत्गुरुं नमामि शरण्यं तमेकं सद्गुरुं स्मरामि श्रुते स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतो वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः ॐ शान्तिः 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 My cordial devotional prostration pranam to all the tutorial deities or devata, whoever is situated here, Swami Chaitanyananda Ji and his disciple, and the Mahatmas, those who are present here with me, revered Swami Medhananda Ji, Swami Haribrahmananda Ji, and other saints, my cordial, respectful Om Namah Narayana to everybody, as well as due respect to all the listeners. Cordial gratitude to Swami Chaitanyananda Ji. He has arranged such a program for us, and nowadays it is very difficult to get such a program that people are not much interested in listening Vedanta. So all the blessings of the God and Guru Parampara should be bestowed on him. It is my prayer. Om. Now, we are discussing here only with the four Mahavakyas. We know that we have four Vedas, Rig, Yaju, Sam, Atharva. The intention of Veda is to establish the unity in the diversity. That is the main intention of Veda. Is it not coming properly? Huh? Little more. Oh. The main intention of all the Vedas is one only, to establish the unity in the diversity. Whatever duality we are seeing in our practical life, that is not the real thing. The what is the reality? In order to prove that thing, Vedas start from what we are doing daily, and he translates or repeat those things, and then he established what is the actual thing, what is the absolute truth that he established. So we think that whatever has narrated in the Veda, everything is absolute. It is not that thing. Standing on the absolute point, you can't deal with the empirical dealing. But you are standing in the empirical side or in the lokik lok vyavahar, then if you try to solve the absolute thing, it will be rather difficult. Now, what is a Mahavakya? Maha means great, Vakya means sentence. But we see Tattvamasi, Ayamatma Brahma, Aham Brahmasmi. These are very small sentences. But why scripture stated it as it is a Mahavakya? Because the meaning of this, and after understanding this meaning of this sentence, the great result comes from it. That's why this sentence has narrated as Mahavakya. Maha means great, and Vakya means the sentence. This sentence has great meaning. that it established the unity. The direct unity is established through this sentence. Though the all the Vedic words of the sentences going to prove that thing only, but this word had specially putting the two or the three words in the samanadhikarana, means in coordination, then it has established that these two things is not different. My portion is only aham brahma asmi. Aham brahma asmi. There are three words. Aham means I. Brahma means that unsurpassable, all pervadingness. Brahma, if we look on its etymological meaning, prakriti and pratyay, brahma dhatu, that is the verbal root, with that manin pratyay, which means the Brahman is the word, it's coming, that means that unsurpassable, untranslatable pervadingness, that is called Brahma. And asmi is the verb, it has come from the verbal root sad. It has come from the verbal root sad, first person singular number present tense. First person singular number present tense. It means at present we all are that thing. But Shastra is telling I when I consider myself alone, I am that thing. Generally what we see, everybody telling, Swamiji, we are doing all the good actions and the deeds, but still I am suffering. Our suffering is not going. But the person, he is doing crime and other things, they are living very nicely. Why it is so? Why it is so? Generally, these questions come to us. You see, in spite of not knowing the fact, we have committed a great mistake. That scripture shows us that mistake you have committed unknowingly. But if we can rectify this mistake, then you can get rid of your sufferings and the sorrow forever. That's why Krishna says like this in Sanak Sujatiya, Annatha Santam Atmanam Annatha Chedridikshati Kim Tenana Kritam Papam Chaurena Atma Apuharina. Annatha Santam Atmanam. What mistake we have committed? We everybody have committed this mistake, that we are considering ourselves as a human being. I am a man, I am a human being. And being a human being, we cannot get rid of our sorrow and the sufferings. Scripture is telling you are not a simple human being. The real status or nature of Atman is not simply a being. It is beyond all beingness. But we know as if we are I am a man or you are a woman or I am a human being. It is animal, it's plants, it's beasts like this. We are considering everything is other than me. This consideration of this type of thoughts gives us. This is the basic reason of our all suffering. Annatha santam atmanam means the real nature of atma is something else. Annatha ched dridikshati, but we want to see ourselves in different way. I am a man, I am a sannyasi, you are a woman, you are a housewife. Like this, we want to deal like this and want to say atma, see atma like this. What mistake or what kim tenana kitam papam, what sin has not been committed by him, one who is stealing his own self or his killing his own self. Kim tenana kitam papam chorena atma paharina. Scripture in Sanak Sujati, it has come, scripture telling this type of person is a thief and he is killing his own self. He is killing his own self. So, not knowing the real nature of the self is the great mistake. And this not understanding of the fact is the root cause of for all misunderstandings, and then all that is the cause of the sufferings and the sorrow. So scripture is saying this, that this is the real nature of the Atma, and we consider ourselves in a different way, and that being the cause of our all suffering. In Isavasya Upanishad, for this type of people, it has told Atmaha. Asurya namate loka andhina tamasabrita tangste pretta bhigachanti jekecha atmahano jana. Atmahana. Here Bhagavan Bhashyakar is writing in his commentary, Atmahana means in Atma being there as it is. Vidyamanasya Atmana Tiraskaranat, the Atma being there as it is in its own nature, but we don't see that thing properly. Here also in Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, in the same Sushtyadi Sarvarupata, in this Brahman from where this Mahavakya has come, in the seventh Kandika, Sruti is showing her grief that tam na pashyati kaschana. Nobody is seeing it, its proper nature. We all are ready to accept the Atma with the limiting adjunct, but without the limiting adjunct, what is its real nature? That we are not seeing. That is the great mistake which we have committed, and that is the root cause of our all suffering. So now, how to know the Atma? How to know the Atma? What is Atma? In order to narrate that thing, first, what are the limiting adjuncts which we are dealing with daily? Stuti shows us that those things. That tat srishta, first thing is tat srishta tadeva anupravishat. Creating the whole world, the creator entered into this created world. Why this word has been told by the Sruti? Because it has come in the four Upanishads in different way. One is Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, Sa Esha Iha Pravishta. In Taittiriya Upanishad, Tat Srishta Tadeva Anupravishat. In Aitiriya Upanishad, Etameva Shimanam Vidar Etayat Dvara Prapadyata. In Chandogya Upanishad, Even Atman Anupravishya Nam Rupe Vyakarvani. In the four Upanishad, it has told that he has entered into this, each and every individual. What is the intention of Shruti? Shruti is telling that if you really wants to know your Atma, then you have to look inside. You have to look inside because he is in everybody. First step. Then why to know Atma and why not the other things? Then scripture is giving four reasoning for that. Atra hi sarve eki bhavanti, because everything submerges into it. Everything crop ups from it, everything sustain in it, and everything dissolve into it. This is the basic reason that if you know the Atma, there is no other anatma vastu is there to know. That's why Shruti is telling tad etat padaniyam anena hi etat sarvam veda. This is the only thing which is fit to be shot. It is fit to be known, because in it everything submerges, and if you know the Atma, everything will be known to you. Third reason is given in this Upanishad only, preyo puttat, preyo virtat, preyo annasmat, sarvasmat. It is the most beloved and dearest thing to all of us. Generally, it is the tendency of the mind that whom I like most, it is the general tendency of the mind, naturally it's going there. Scripture is telling that Atma is the dearest thing. The full explanation of this word has come in Maitreya Brahman. Naba are pattu kamaya pati priya bhavati atmanastu kamaya sarvam priyam bhavati. This is the third reason that Atma is the dearest thing or the nearest thing in the world. So we should know only Atma. And fourth reason has given in scripture only that yad ihava anevambit Mahat punnam karma karati tadha asya antata chiyate eva. One who does not know Atma, what is the real nature of Atma? Even he does the greatest virtue or the religious action, still ultimately it will perish. And again he will have to come down. Chine punne marta lokam vishanti. So these are the four reasons behind, it has been shown by the Sruti, behind this, that why one should know Atma. Very initially I told, in order to get rid of the all sufferings and the sorrow, the only one thing is there, that we have to know yourself. Go on inquiring, who am I? And search and sort that thing. Then we can understand. But we have to go according to the scripture. How scripture has showed like this? Because different philosopher has had got different opinion about the Atma. Somebody is telling body is Atma. Somebody is telling beyond body, I am the agent and enjoyer. Doer and enjoyer. Karta bhokta. Somebody is telling like this. That is Nyaya darshan, Mimamsa darshan. Vaisheshik Darshan, they are telling like this. And Atma is different than from Paramatma. Shankara Darshan is telling Purush is only an enjoyer, the doer is Prakriti. Like this, no different philosopher has got different idea. Therefore, we confuse what is the real nature of Atma. So it is better to take resort on the lotus feet of Shruti, as he is narrating, and as our traditional teacher shows us how you can know your Atma. We cannot directly think about Atma, because Atma is beyond our speech, any sense organ, any mind and the intellect. It's beyond all these things. But Atma is there. You can experience that thing. I am. And that I am is Sakshad Aparokshad Brahma. Means it is the nearest and without being interrupted by anything. That Atma is like this. But we are not understanding that thing. We are considering with this limiting adjunct, I am a human being. And then along with this, I am a male or female, like this type of consideration we are doing, and accordingly we are dealing. And so scripture is telling, now you try to remove this idea that I can stay only with the limiting adjunct. The limiting adjunct is illumined by me, and through those limiting adjunct only you can see Atma, because no energy you can perceive by your sense organ, even electrical energy, light energy, sound energy, whatever energies we are seeing in our practical life, it is we can perceive that thing or you can experience that thing by virtue of some other, with the help of some limiting adjunct. If I ask you what is electricity, nobody can tell me what is electricity. It's an energy. But if you see the fan, light, freeze, heater, like this, no, that energy is exposed to that thing. Similarly, Atma means the root cause of the whole universe is the unanimous mass of energy, according to the scientists also. Now they are also searching like this, that unanimous mass of energy. In order to understand that energy, we have to take help of some limiting adjunct. So scripture also saying the Atma with body, mind and intellect. But now the process is neti neti. You have to negate all this limiting adjunct, and then whatever the ultimate substratum will remain, that is the self. That is the self. This is the procedure. Now then Kandika means Srishtyadi Sarvarupata. This is the fourth Brahman of the first chapter of Brihadaranyaka Upanishad. It is from Shukla Yajurveda. And in this Brahman only, in the tenth Kandika, means tenth mantra, the Brihadaranyaka mantras are termed as Kandika. And each small canto is termed as Brahmana. So in the fourth Brahmana of the first chapter, its name is Srishtyadi Sarvarupata, means creation is the beginning of the all names and the forms. In this, Vidya Sutra and description of the Avidya, both are there. Knowledge as well as the what is the ignorant part, that has also described here. The knowledge has stated here in aphorism form. Vidya Sutra, Atma Itteva Upashita. Why? That I have told you the four reasons behind that. Now, in between this Vidya Sutra and before telling what is Atma, that is Brahma, one question has put by Shruti herself. Tad ahu, jad brahma vidya sarvam bhavishyatva manushya manyante. Tad ahu means it has been told by Brahmana. Brahmana means those who are seekers of Brahma, not by the caste Brahmana. Bhagavan Bhaskara said him, Brahmana, Brahma vividishoho, vividishavah. Those who are seeker of Brahma, they are Brahmana. It is generally told by them that I will become all by knowing something. Jad manushyamanda brahma vidya, by knowing brahma I will become all. And then the Shruti is telling, kimu tad brahma vid jasmat tad sarvam bhavat. What that brahma? No. That due to result of that he become all. He became all. What that brahma no? So, now, just see two words are put here. First, manushya manyante. And after that Shruti is telling, kim tad brahma avet. First, it had shown that manushya manyante, human being are thinking like this, by brahma vidya we will become all. And afterwards, Shruti herself is telling, kim tad brahma avet. What that brahma no? Due to which he became all. So here, Suti's intention is Brahma and Manusha is not different. First word is this. But here, by putting this question, that Kim Tad Brahma Abed, it has divided into two parts. Means, what is that Brahma, whether it is limited or unlimited? Why this question is coming? Because if it is unlimited, it cannot be the object of your perception. The unlimited thing cannot be the object of our sense organ, neither body, nor mind, nor intellect. Neither any of the sense organ. But then let us consider it as limited one. If it is a limited one, then automatically it will be a perishable thing. The result of that also will be a temporary thing. First, these doubts are coming. Secondly, kim tad brahma abed, kim abed. If it is by knowing something, it's become all, then it is a product or the effect. Automatically the result will not be a permanent thing. It will be a temporary thing. So what will be the difference between the fruits of your action and between the your knowledge? What will be the difference? That fruit is also a temporary thing. This knowledge, result of this knowledge will also be a temporary thing. Automatically there is no use of knowledge. That's why Shruti herself put this question here, that kim tad brahma, what is that brahma, whether it's qualified brahma or unqualified brahma, whether it is limited or unlimited. First thing, if it is limited, then it will be a temporary thing. If it is unlimited, then it cannot be the object of our knowledge. So this defect will come. And moreover, in second, kim tad abed, if by knowing something, if you are getting the result of the all, that I will become all, then also this result will be a temporary thing. Or if it is not knowing anything, then that should be applicable for us also, that not knowing anything, I will become all. But it is not narrated in the scripture, then all the scripture will be useless, because scripture is telling Guru Shishya Tad Vidhi Pranipatena Pariprasthena Sevaya Tad Vignartham Sa Guru Meva Abhigachya Samitapani Kshatriyam Brahmanishta. Like this, no? Scripture is telling that this is the utility of the Guru, Shishya and teaching. But if not knowing anything, if you can become all, then what will be the utility of the scripture? Like this, the four questions come from this question. Bhagavan Bhashyakar is telling, our commentator is telling, that sarva dosha anagandhitam, bereft of any flaw and the faults, scripture is giving reply. How it is giving reply? Then this mantra comes. Brahma vaidamagra asit tadatmanam eva aved aham brahmasmiti tasmat tat sarvam abhavat. My portion is up to this. I will not go further. This is brahma va idam agre asit. In the beginning, alone was there. Sa atmanam eva aved. It knows itself only. How? That I am that supreme Brahma. Like this the sentence is coming, and as a result of that, it become all. Now, aham brahmasmi. I told you my word is only this much. So, now question is coming, that what is this Brahma? Is it qualified Brahma or unqualified Brahma? Or it is something else than Brahma. It is something else than Brahma. Before Bhashyakara, there are two commentators. One is Vrittikar Bodhayana Acharya. One is Varti Prapancha. They have explained it in this manner. Is Brahma cannot be the unqualified Brahma, that Bodhayana Acharya, his intention is this. It cannot be the unqualified Brahma. It should be the qualified Brahma, because unqualified Brahma is already all-pervading. Automatically, it is useless for him to know Brahma again and to become the all-pervading. It is not, there will be the now utility of this type of advice. So therefore, our Bodhayan Acharya is telling, it is better to take the qualified Brahma, Hiranyagarbha. He will know himself as that I am the all-pervading entity, and as a result of that, he will become the unqualified Brahma. First group, one. Second group is telling that no, it is not like that. It is our general idea. And we cannot come up with this idea that I am different than Brahma. Brahma is something else and I am human being something else. And by doing upasana, by worshipping the qualified Brahma, I will attain the oneness with the qualified Brahma. And since I have got that discretion, automatically I will ignore the all results by virtue of which I can become that Hiranyagarbha, that also to be ignored. Then, by seeking that Brahma, I will become that unqualified Brahma. This is the procedure. This appeals us that this person is telling correctly that I am a human being, I am other than Brahma. First I will do Upasana, by that my Antakkaran will become clear, Antakkaran Shuddhi, and then that with the knowledge I will become the unqualified or the all-pervading Brahma. But if it is so, what defect will come? That Bhashyakar is telling. And third party is this, what Siddhanti Paksha is telling. No, it is unqualified Brahma and it is always there. No question of any transmigration or no question of any modification, deformation, nothing is there. Simply due to ignorance you are considering yourself that I am such and so. In order to remove that ignorance only, we need this word. We need this word. No, you are not that. Just see, now we have the idea, aham manushya asmi. Aham manushya asmi. So due to this idea, or due to this confirmed knowledge, we are behaving like a human being. We are not behaving like a bird or like a beast or like a plants, because it is inherent to us. And we accepted this thing. Mannata diya humne isko, ki main manushya hun, that I am a human being. But scripture is telling, as long you will have this agreement or this type of idea in you, you will not be able to free from your sufferings and the sorrow. This is the third group. But Bhagavan Bhashyakar, before telling his own theory or the whatever has been established by the scripture, he is first showing the defect. If you consider yourself as a human being, and by doing something, if you are attaining any result, that result cannot be a permanent thing. That's why Bhagavan Bhashyakar is telling that the first group is, it is an unqualified Brahma, he is trying to become qualified. And second group is Manushya Bhavi, Bhavi Brahma Bhavi Purush. First I am Manushya, I will become Brahma by doing Upasana. First by doing Upasana, then after that by knowing that Brahma, I will become Brahma. Then Bhagavan Bhashyakar is telling, Tanna Sarva Bhavapattir Anityatva Doshat. If it is not possible, because if it is a product or if it is a result of your knowledge, then it will be anitya. Anitya means temporary. Because it has not seen in the world the product or effect, and it is a eternal thing, it has not seen in the world. Whatever product or effect we are seeing in the world, that perish. Automatically, Bhashyakar is telling, na sa asti loke parma nitya vasat bhavantaram apadyate nityascha. This is the defect. If by knowing, means it is a sarva bhava apatti. If it is a result of some action, means it may be a physical action, it may be a mental action. Upasana is a mental action. If by virtue of that, if you attain the state of allness or the all-pervadingness, then automatically it will be a temporary thing. So, therefore, it is better to consider that previously also it was unqualified Brahma, at present also I am unqualified Brahma, and by knowing Brahma, my mistake will go. In spite of dealing as a human being, but my I-ness and my-ness, which is the means ego and egocentric selfish desire, these two things will go. If you can know yourself as that I am that all-pervading entity, then automatically ego will go. And when ego has gone, then egocentric selfish desire, which is the root cause of our all suffering, that will also go. That is the intention, main intention of the Shruti. So Bhagavan Bhashyakar is telling, before knowing also he was Brahma, at present also he is Brahma, after knowing also he will become Brahma. Because if you are really not a Brahma, simply human being other than Brahma, then never expect that you can become Brahma. It is not possible. There is no capacity in the knowledge or in upasana, in the vritti, to change the thing. It simply reveals the thing as the thing is there. It means it simply removes the ignorance. Not it is creating anything, neither it's destroying anything. The knowledge has got no capacity to create anything or to destroy anything. It simply removes the ignorance. Automatically, if I am not Brahma, if I am different from Brahma, then never expect that you will become Brahma, or you can remove, or you can get rid of your all sufferings. Then there will be no use of the scripture also, because scripture is narrating like this only, that in the, from your very nature, you are the supreme Brahma. So, now, sometime we use the word in a secondary sense also, in primary sense and secondary sense. The Purupaksha is telling, here it is used in the secondary sense. But Siddhant is telling, in the secondary and primary sense, if it is possible to take the primary sense, then it is not wise to accept the secondary sense. If there is no other intention, greater intention than there is, then you cannot change it like that. So, Brahma word has its original meaning, that unqualified Brahma. So if it is possible to take that meaning, then it will not be wise to take a different meaning other than the unqualified Brahma, if there is no other greater intention behind that. So, now he is telling that no, it is not possible that abrahmatva or sarvatva is a real thing, Purupakshi is telling. As we are seeing that I am not Brahma, anybody, if I ask you, who are you? You will tell, I am Mr. So-and-so, his daughter or his wife or his son like this, or my guru is this like this. This is our general identification. But scripture is, that's why Purupaksha is telling that naturally, and it is true that we are not Brahma, we are not all. So automatically, by virtue of upasana, we will become that thing. Bhagavan Bhaskar is telling, no, then never expect that you will become Brahma. If you are not Brahma, then never expect that you can become Brahma. We are Satkarjavadi. Satkarjavadi means the thing which is existing. You can only reveal that thing. The thing which is not existing there, it cannot manifest. That's why Bhagavan Sri Krishna is telling Bhagavad Gita that nasate vidyate bhava na bhava vidyate sat. So if that thing is not there, then you cannot become that thing. A thing cannot change to the other thing by virtue of simply upasana or knowledge. It is not possible. The thing is there, and simply knowledge, what is this? It reveals that thing. That is the work of the knowledge. So, in order to get rid of all sufferings and etc., there is no other way to know the real nature of the self or to take resort to the supreme feet of the Lord. Just see, in scripture and in Ramcharitmanas also it has come that it may be possible that sometime you can roll the sky like a paper, but without knowledge it is not possible to get rid of the sufferings and your sorrow. In Ramcharitmanas also it has told by Tulsidasji that it may be possible that sometime you can get ghee by churning water. It may be possible that by grinding sand you may get oil. But it is never possible, without taking resort to the supreme feet of the Lord, you can get free from your all sufferings. So, scripture is telling you have to know yourself, that who you are. Okay, if we cannot understand that subtle thing properly at the very beginning, now still, when you are thinking the Lord, don't think that He is other than me. Scripture is telling, Nasa Veda, Anna Asu, Anna Hamasmi, Nasa Veda, Pashurevasa Devanam. If you are thinking that God is other than me, or the gods are other than me, then you are not knowing the thing. You will become an animal, a beast of the gods. So, whenever we are thinking about the Lord, or whenever, if you can think about the self, automatically the self itself is there, you will think in yourself only. But if you are thinking about the God also, think that He is in me only. I and He is not the two different entities. We are the same. Okay, I am not understanding the fact. Still, if it is different, then never we can become one. So, like this Bhagavan Bhaskar is telling, that if it is not paramarthikam, Then never expect that you will become Brahma. But just see, is it wise to consider that in, because Brahma is one only, is it wise to consider that ignorance in Brahma? It is not wise to consider that there is ignorance in Brahma. Then Bhagavan Bhaskar is telling, just see, the scripture is advising that sadeva idamagre ashit atmaiva idagum sarvam brahmaiva idagum sarvam naidam daitam asti abrahma. Whatever the duality we are seeing, that is not other than the Brahma. Like this, when we are advising like this, just see, when you are telling naidam rajatam yam shukti, it means we have committed some mistake about that substratum. We are considering the mother of pearl as a shuktika. That's why some good man or some teacher tells us, just see, it is not the rajatam, it is shukti. Similarly, when we commit mistake about the rope, that it is a snake, it is not a rope, then scripture or the teacher is telling us, just see, noyam sarpa, yam rajju. Like this, this type of upadesh is only possible when some mistake has been committed. Otherwise, this type of upadesh is not, advice is not possible. Here also, when scripture is telling sadeva summa idam agre ashit, atva atma idam agre ashit, brahma idam agre ashit, atva nedam daitam asti abrahma, like this, this type of advice is coming, it means we have committed some mistake about the Brahma or about ourselves. That's why scripture is telling naidam rajatam yam shukti, naidam jagatam yam brahma, naidam jagatam, no, neither this is male, female, nothing is this, it's only atma. Like this advice or this type of upadesh is only possible when the mistake is there. Otherwise, Shruti could not say like this. But see, okay, the superimposition is there, I do agree. But who has superimposed this thing? This question has come in Brahmasutra also. Generally, it has seen that we are superimposing something which is in front of me and not knowing the thing. Something is there, but what is that thing? That is not known to me. Then we superimpose something in mother of pearl, it is a rajatam, or in rope, we are considering it as a snake, like this. But here, atma, it is not a different thing than me you are telling. So who has done this superimposition? This is the difference between the example and the exemplified. In the, while giving the example, we are telling that shuktika, or this is rajju, sarpa, shuktika, rajatam. But this is other than me. But here, how the mistake is possible by the self? In the self. By the self, in the self, this type of mistake is not possible. That's why the question is coming. Bhavati evam na avidya kratya brantava brantava brahma. But Brahma cannot be the author, or the, he cannot be the ignorant people. Okay, superimposition is there, but superimposition is generally done by in front of something. Giving reply to this question or giving reply to this doubt, in Brahmasutra Bhagavan Bhaskar is telling, just see, sky is not visible by us. It is not the object of our perception, but still we consider the sky as if is it a hemispherical. And we consider that it has a color also, it's a blue color. The sky is not the object of our perception, but still we consider it's the sky is it is a hemispherical thing, and it has a color also blue. So it is possible that in spite of not being an object of our perception, we are superimposing the thing. This is the example for that. Similarly, in Brahma also this thing has done, and moreover, atma is not a thing which is not at all known by us. We know atma, that I am here, but we know in a different way. That is the mistake. So Shruti wants to remove that mistake from us. Therefore, Shruti, this type of doubts are arose by the Bhagavan Bhaskar, that atma by itself cannot commit any mistake in itself. How it is possible? Then Bhagavan Bhaskar, here he is giving reply. In Brahma Sutra he is replied in different. One Bhaskar, just see. Just see, here in the scripture, it has told, there is only one entity. There is no other thing than Brahma. Na anno ato asti drashti, na anno ato asti vijnatri, na anno ato asti vijnata, atmanam eva avet aham brahmasmi, na anno aso annaham asmi na sa veda. Like these, those who know that he is different, I am different, they have got no real knowledge. But there is only one observer. No other observer is there. So if there is duality, then this type of mistake could have happened. But scripture is telling there is no other else other than Brahma. So now scripture is telling the Atma Vedam Sarvam, the superimposition is there. But the superimposition in the self, by the self, how it is possible? Then Bhagavan Bhaskar is telling the scripture is telling like this. So automatically the mistake has been committed by us. Scripture knows that thing. That's why Shastra is telling like this. That there is beyond Brahma, other than Brahma, there is nothing else. So if it is right or wrong, whatever it may be, that is in Brahma only. If it is like that only, if there is Brahma only, then what is, where is the need of the scripture and guru and the sishya, all these dealings? There is no need of that thing. But we are seeing that guru, sishya and advice and wise, getting the advice or the upadesha and doing in accordance to the advice of the guru, we can know ourselves and get the result of that thing, that we get free from the all type of misery. That's why at the end of Bhagavad Gita, Arjuna is telling, Nashtas moho smritir labdha. In the end of the Prashna Upanishad, the students are telling, Tam hina pita jasmakam abhidaya paramparam taresi tadha bijigyo tadha bijigyo. In this way, the Shetketu has also told, automatically the effect of the advice is there, and the result of that thing is being experienced by the human being. Automatically you cannot say it is not that. That means you cannot say it is a mistake, which is an established fact. It is an established fact that guru, shishya, parampara, teachers and the advice and doing accordingly, you get the result. It is an established fact. So you cannot deny that thing. Nahi drishtir anupapanna nama. Nahi drishtir anupapanna nama. What we are seeing, you cannot say it is illogical. It is established thing, so automatically you cannot say it illogical. In this way, when Siddhanti Paksha is telling that there is only one thing, then Purapaksha is coming with different way. Just see, in scripture, the duality is there. It has explained there, the duality. How? Prakarantarena shankam karoti. Bhagavamara, this tikakari samprati prakarantarena purvapaksheti. In a different way, Purapaksha is coming. Just see, the scripture is telling, Punno vai punnena karmana papa papena tam vidda karmani samanvara bhete. If we do the good actions, then we will get the good result. And when we depart from this body, then upasana and karma goes with us. And manta, buddha, karta, vijnanatma, purusha, there is one jivatma who is karta, bhokta, manta, like this. This type of means parma, this jiva is other than paramatma. This type of advice is there in scripture. And Paramatma is shown in different way. Neti neti, ashanaya adi atita, jatma apahata papma bijaro bimritti bushyoko. Like this, no, that jeep is other than Paramatma, and Paramatma is other than jeep. It has explained in Upanishad also. So how you are telling that there is only one entity, Brahma? It is not wise to say like this. That is, the objection is coming in that manner. And moreover, the other philosophers are also telling that duality is true. Kanat, Vaisheshikavarjo, Gautam, they are telling that duality. Jivatma is other than Paramatma. Atma is two. They are considering Atma as a drabya, as a substance. And it is two. One is Jivatma, another is Paramatma. Paramatma is one and Jivatma is infinity by number. So like this, that, and moreover, by worshipping the Paramatma, we are getting pleasure, we are getting the result that is described here, ki, that tam viditta nalipyate papakena brahma vidapnoti param ekadhaiva anudashtrabhyam yobayetad aksharam gargi aviditva aur viditva. Like this, no, it has told by the scripture that Paramatma is different than Jivatma, and Jivatma is the karta, Paramatma is the karma. By virtue of his good result, he gets Paramatma. Like this it has told in the scripture. So how you are telling that there is only one thing? Moreover, it has told in the scripture that there are two paths. One is oriented with the northern region, another is with the southern region, that is Uttarayan and Dakshinayan. This, to get the result of your own action, the path's description is also there. So how you are telling that Jivatma or Paramatma is one only? They are two different things. So automatically we have to go accordingly that these two are different things. Then Bhagavan Bhashyakar, moreover, that Jiv is Alpagya and all desires, longings are there. Longing and belonging, both are there in the jiva. But in Paramatma or Ishwar, he is aptakama. There is no desire in himself. Automatically, how you are telling this complete different two things that there, it has described in the scripture, you are telling that only one entity is that Brahma. It is not wise to consider like this. When Purapaksha is telling like this, then Siddha Bhagavan Bhashyaka is telling, Brahma Upadesha Anarthakku Prasanga. This is Sangrahavakya. This advice of Brahma. Advice of Brahma means you are Brahma. This type of Upadesh will become useless. If you say like this, that these two are the different thing, then this type of the advice or this type of the words will become useless. Then just see, the two parts, if I consider that Jivatma and Paramatma is two different thing, then this type of advice will useless. And if I consider these two are one only, then this type of, that means by doing some action we'll get some result by virtue of your own action, then this part will become useless. Just see what the state has come. If you consider that there is only one unity, then the whatever the scripture part is, there karma kanda and upasana, these two parts will become useless. And if you consider there is only one Brahma, these two parts will be useless. And if you consider that this is the right part, automatically this part will become useless. That unity, only one thing is there. If karmakanda and upasana is become predominant, then this part, the unity part, will become useless. The if you give the predominancy in the unity, then automatically the karma and upasana, this part will become useless. Then what is the real thing to understand? Then Bhagavan Bhashyakar is telling, okay, see that what result has shown in the karma and upasana, and what result has shown in the knowledge. Because a knowledge, it's the there is nothing to do, just to know the thing. We are not getting anything new from that thing, but in the karma and upasana you are getting a new thing. Automatically whatever things we are achieving by virtue of some action, that is a temporary thing. So do you be in a temporary happiness? You ask anybody, everybody wants to live in happiness only. Yes, I do agree. But do you like to be in that happiness for 1 day, or 2 days, or for 3 days, or for 1 month, or 1 year, or for 5 years? No, sir. It is general nature that whenever you are getting a new thing, then we become happy. But after a few minutes or a few years, we become unhappy. So it has seen experimentally, and it is experienced by everybody, whatever result you are getting by through our actions or the upasana, that is a temporary thing. That's why the other alternative, that athato brahma jikyasa. That's why this inquiry starts, who am I, what is Brahma? Like this inquiry starts. So automatically Bhagavan Bhashyakar is telling, just see, I do agree there are two parts in the Veda. But this thing, if you consider this thing is the predominant thing, then automatically the unity or the real nature of the Brahma will be covered, and you will not be able to get rid of the sufferings and the sorrow. But if you know the thing properly, then all the sufferings and the sorrow will go forever. Now you ask yourself that to which part you want to give importance. More importance. If you want to be in happiness, but temporary happiness, and you want to be in happiness, forever happiness, and your sorrow and the suffering should go forever. Everybody wants that my sorrow and the suffering should go forever. So this is the only way to know the real nature of the self. So let me stop here, because in the evening also I will get some time. Now, if something is not understood properly, Brahmachari Bhanu Chaitanya will explain it in the local language. And if any doubt is there, then I can clarify that thing. Okay? So, where I stopped, in which part we have to give the importance. Okay. Now, we will come to the next step. I will conclude. Now, Bhanu Chaitanya will